On today's Saturday Doobie Feature, the internet's first movies and marijuana show, we're gonna go Godzilla! That's for the kids. You probably don't. It's Rock Band.
This is my banjo.
Your Guitar Hero.
Banjo Band.
Godzilla! Well, hey, everybody. Welcome back to the Saturday Doobie Feature. I'm your host, Justin.
I'm Byron.
We're missing Derek today, but we have one big special guest. Maybe you've heard of him. Godzilla. I tried to make that as least racist as possible, because it's hard.
Yeah, you can't.
You really want to, like, say it like they used to, but you can't.
You just can't.
This is the 2014 remake after 23 Toho movies. In 1999, the Janjira nuclear plant was mysteriously destroyed, with most hands lost, including Supervisor Joe Brody's colleague and wife, Sandra. Years later, Joe's son, Ford, a U.S. Navy ordnance disposal officer, must go to Japan to help his estranged father, who obsessively searches for the truth of the incident. And in doing so, father and son discover the disaster's secret cause on the wreck's very ground. This enables them to witness the reawakening of a terrible threat to all of humanity, which is made all the worse with a second revival elsewhere against the cataclysm. The only hope for the world may be Godzilla, but the challenge for the king of the monsters will be great even as humanity struggles to understand the destructive ally they may possibly have. That almost sounded... It sounds way more exciting than what we watched.
Yeah, you made it sound way more exciting, honestly.
They should have just had me read the script. And been like, Godzilla does this! Rawr!
No, I'm just
kidding.
Come in with the puppet. Godzilla destroying the city.
Thank you, Urban Collective. I gotta get stoned before I talk about this movie. I don't try to be really negative. I don't want to be negative, Mr. Negative.
Mm-hmm. Gotta harness in the good energy, block out the bad. Harness, energy, block, bad. Uh-huh. Feel the flow, happy. Feel it.
You know? I will. Hi. I haven't been here on the show for a while.
How are you? Where have you been? Hi, how are you? Where you been? Oh, he's just one track mind.
Well, besides
this is the second American remake of Godzilla after, you know, my heart's love of 1998's Hank Azaria starring Godzilla, which was, you know, very famous for its rendition of Come With Me. That was Puff Daddy sampling Led Zeppelin.
Is that the one with the Metal Godzilla?
No. Metal Godzilla is Mecha Godzilla, which they haven't done in the American versions.
Oh.
That was why... So, okay. Godzilla in my youth and in my upbringing was always a really, really cool thing to me. Because, like, I felt like it was foreign, it was unique, but it also... It felt like never-ending. Like, I felt like I was always learning more about, like, more kaiju and more Godzilla and, like... There's Godzilla versus Gojira, and there's King Gojira, and there's, like, the little Godzilla movie where they're on the island, and Godzilla has the little baby Godzilla. I'd like to show the little baby Godzilla if you've never seen it. He's adorable. But the point is, it really felt like something to explore as a kid. So when they went to make this remake, I think everyone was really excited, because, you know, we kind of know what we're in for, but I think they went a little bit too realistic to what the actual Godzilla movies used to be like.
I would say realistic in the sense of, yeah, they made it look like this epica's like Godzilla, you know, with technology and all that, but...
Well, you don't even see him.
Well, you only see him for like 8 fucking minutes.
In the dark. Swimming around.
You know what it looked like?
If a plane explodes, you can't watch that movie on an in-flight movie.
That is true. But you know what it looked like? It reminded me of the scenes from Monsters, Inc. That extra scene where, like, Rex is just coming in. You just see the foot.
Hey, Ted! Good morning!
Roar!
Cut. Hey, how was that? Was I scary? Do I get the part?
Thank you.
Can I do it again? I can be taller!
Next.
Besides Godzilla sounding like Jurassic Park, it was cool. It was a good movie.
What do you mean it was a good movie?
I mean, it's just
like... You just
like,
came in saying you were going to hate on it. Listen.
I mean...
Listen, they teased us with the Bryan Cranston bullshit. Let's get this out of the way right now.
Yeah, they killed him.
They try to do this little... that's spoilers. Thanks. No, but I'm not even... I don't care that they
killed
him.
Killed one of the best characters.
I don't care that they kill him. I care that... They made me think that Bryan Cranston was going to hold my hand through this Godzilla movie. I really thought he was going to be like the hero of the day. I thought he was going to be the Hank Azaria of this movie.
Well, we got the sun.
Who cares about the sun? This movie is filled with some of the most plastic actors I've ever seen. Elizabeth Olsen looks like she took 3 Xanax as there's like a giant lizard monster walking by her building. Like, you're in a hospital, everyone's dying, everything's destroyed, and everyone's like, yes, doctor, we will go. Okay, yes, thank you.
You know what she had? Bars.
She's got bars, wow. It's a joke for the drug kids. Listen, I'm holding on to this bong today because I feel a little under the weather, and you don't want to be that guy.
Don't be that guy.
Okay, you don't want to be the guy getting your friend sick. If you can't bring your own to the party, stay home. Okay? It's okay. Right? That's not a marijuana minute. That's just me like trying to talk about.
That's just facts of life.
Don't fuck up your friend's week, because you know it takes time. That's what I learned. I learned that, you know, when you get infected like with a cold or something, it has to deal with the amount of people that you live with. And it's like every person you live with is an extra 3 days. So that's why some people get sick like after a week and some people get sick like immediately.
Makes sense why I'm always sick like 2 weeks.
Why? Because you live with like 80 people?
Yeah.
That was not enough.
Anyway.
We both went at the same time. But we can't do that. So, a very boring movie about... No, I hate to say it like that. You know, you want to be positive. But I think that it's boring because it is a tribute to a movie that was made in 1954.
No, I don't think that. I think it was just the fucking characters that are boring. Okay. Godzilla itself is not boring at all.
No. He's the king of the monsters.
I mean, at one point...
But they don't mean.
At one point, he was just fighting 2 monsters by himself. Fucking the reason Utah why he's called monsters, Godzilla.
Which was weird. Well, which is weird. Like, you're gonna do a Godzilla movie. I get it. You don't want to bring in any of the heavy hitters. You have, like, little, like, hints to Mothra and stuff in there. But then, like, you make these other weird, like, creatures, and they're like, there's no rules.
You just bring this one flying creature and then this one, like, Cloverfield-looking motherfucker in, and then you're just like, bam, Godzilla.
Right. But, like, so much of what they do is convenient. And it's bad. It's bad writing. It's bad storytelling. Like, these monsters love nuclear energy, right? And they crave it. And they can, like, detect where high levels of nuclear energy is. So what they do is they try to trick the monsters with a train carrying nuclear energy to where they want the monsters to be. Why wouldn't the monsters just go to the train station where they know the nuclear energy is? They're smart monsters. It doesn't make any sense. It's like when Godzilla is swimming and he like swims under the boat, but all the other boats get blown up. Like, it's just like, why? Hey,
but when he goes under that one boat, that's pretty fucking rad, right? You're just like, oh,
because Bryan Cranston was on that boat and he wasn't allowed to destroy that boat for another 20 minutes or something.
He just wasn't allowed to die yet. That's the real Not yet. Reason.
They were like, we need at least 30 minutes of screen time for you. Shit. Here's a dab of the Raw Garden. Thank you, Urban Collective, always hooking it up for us. Raw Garden, this is some kosher chem number 41. You know, you love it when they get you with those phenotypes. Don't try the kosher chem 40. It was terrible. Kosher chem 41 is where it's at. I assume it's some, like, biscotti gelato mix with the chem and the... And see, what I'm going to do is take my little... sanitizing napkin.
You got not cleared yet.
Well, that's your problem. Sorry, sassy. I don't want to be rude.
So sassy.
I am sassy. I feel like I'm sassy pants. I feel like when Derek's not here, I have to be like a little bit more sassy because he keeps me in check.
You have to do the roles of 2 characters.
He's like oh yeah, I have to be Derek and him. I can't do that. I'm not a. It's like a chocolate chip cookie. I'm not that. You know. So I was going to say a yin and a yang. Because we're good partners. We balance each other out. We're very yin and yang. You know, we're definitely not from the same school. But that's why we work so well as partners together. And that's why me and you work so well as partners together. We balance each other out.
Because we're opposites.
Kind of like how they don't balance anything with Godzilla in this movie. Because he's only in it for 6 minutes.
Yeah. And like the 6 minutes that he's in it, it's just like... It's just memorable scenes, you know? Like, I can see why people would love to watch this movie a couple years down the road. Other than that, it's just like, you're gonna be in for a fucking disappointment. Let me tell you that first.
Well, that's
of all.
The problem is, like, after you look at Godzilla, like, what do you do if there's... I mean, that's why they have to add those creatures in there, because you have to have Godzilla, like, destroying something. You look at Godzilla, that's, like, the big thing. You're like, oh, wow, he's here, it's massive. And then if he's not fighting another monster or something compelling like that...
It's like, what the fuck am I watching?
What do I... Why, he's just existing. He's just chilling. Godzilla's just chilling.
He's not really doing much, but unless
he fights. Well, apparently he was awakened in 1999 with the... No, but if you want to watch a good movie about monsters beating each other up, Kong Skull Island. That was 2016.
Woo!
John C. Reilly.
I've seen some parts here and there.
That's a good ass movie.
I'm not gonna lie.
And I'm telling you, King Kong fights an octopus.
It's like one of those things where it's like on HBO, you watch it if it's midway and you're just like, all right, maybe it's pretty good, you know? Like, I saw the scene.
Of the scale.
I saw like 10 minutes of the scene where like Samuel L. Jackson's on the freaking helicopter and then he's about to like, he gets shot down. He's like, you ain't gonna kill my men. And then in like 5 seconds, King Kong kills all his men. You know,
they're all dead. Oh, yeah.
It's like one of those movies. I'll get to it eventually, I think.
John C. Reilly's there. It's great. This just became a Kong Skull Island episode. Well, I just forgot that Samuel L. Jackson was in that movie.
Are you hoping for like a future King Kong versus Godzilla movie?
Well, they've talked about that.
It's in the works.
Which to me, I don't see the excuse me scale of economics.
Mm-hmm.
Kong looks pretty small in his universe. I've been on the ride at Universal. I've seen him up close. He's not as large as Godzilla. He can't... Maybe...
But he is in the old movies.
What if it's King Kong and Godzilla? What if it's like a Batman versus Superman, but they really have to work together? So, like, it's really like King Kong, like, on, like, Godzilla's back. And he's like, oh, fucking... Fuck you up! And he like, throws him. And it's like the Hulk and Wolverine.
King Kong is basically Diddy Kong. With Godzilla.
He'd be more like King Kruel. This metaphor is going way too far.
King Kruel and Diddy Kong. The movie.
That Super Smash Brothers.
CGI and everything.
2023. Look for it.
Fuck.
I can't believe they didn't set that up at the end of Detective Pikachu. I really thought they were going to be like, you know, Mario
just know,
comes out.
We said it first. Copyright it right here. Movie feature. Y'all gonna have to cut us a check. This ain't no joke.
They're gonna have to cut us a check for the Super Smash Bros. Movie. You know, I think at the end of Detective Pikachu, somebody should have walked out of the shadows.
I still haven't seen it.
No. I'm just saying it should have been like a guy with a mustache and a little plumber's hat. And he like hands the thing to Pikachu and he's like, we need you for something, you know? And then it starts off from there. And then,
are you talking about Wario at the end?
No, I'm talking about Mario handing Pikachu the Smash Brothers initiative paperwork.
What if it was Waluigi that did it?
That would be a twist. And now you've ruined the twist for the audience.
It's just ideas.
These are ideas. Just
they don't know anything.
That's Papa's piece. See, I'm getting a little drippies. That's how you could tell.
Huh?
I'm getting a little drippies. I just don't feel good. I'm sick. Listen, we'll talk to you guys about it after this marijuana minute. Hey guys, on today's marijuana minute, we're going to give a shout out to Made Gallery LA, which was the home of our awesome event a couple weeks back. If you were there, I mean, Byron, you were there. Tell the people.
I was there. I mean, it was awesome. There was bud, there was beer, there was people, and it was a good time.
I don't know. My ears are burning because I'm feeling like it sounds like a good time to me. Listen, thank you, Made Gallery, Monster Hop, Valley Bevco.
Okay.
And we're back.
So, to wrap it up, most memorable scenes in the end for me while I was high as fuck was basically when it was a military guy. Mm-hmm. The sun, and it was Godzilla. They looked at each other, and then he just disappeared into the smoke. Oh man, cool emotional effect. It's really stupid as fuck, but
yeah.
Ooh, cool.
That was your favorite part?
No.
Stupid as fuck.
No, my favorite part. My favorite part was when he was basically what's that thing where you like give another person the smoke, a shotgun?
Yeah, shoddy.
Yeah, when he basically shotgunned the other creature to death. That shit was funny as fuck. He's just like, come here.
I was talking about that with someone the other day. I was like, I can't believe we used to do that. We used to take our spit cover blunts that we all... You know how much of my friend's spit that I've incidentally smoked over the years? You really think about it. It's kind of weird. But then...
You know how much your immune system has gotten stronger, though?
This is true. And then you flip it around in your mouth, and then you would blow it out into someone else. We were trashy kids.
So would you say Godzilla's trashy for shotgunning?
I think that's why people like Godzilla. Godzilla used to be a cult classic trashy. You know, something you put on at parties, and it wasn't really... serious. I mean, like, people in Japan took it more serious, but it's more of like a, you know, a cultural, I don't know. Do people take sumo wrestling seriously here? You know?
I don't know, but it's pretty fucking serious. Them motherfuckers.
But that's what I'm saying. Exactly. And there it's taken more seriously. And that's why there's more respect for the Godzilla movies there than there is here, even though it's a classic, you know, part of cinema. Just saying. It's a little parallel. I'm Justin. Find me at places. I do stuff.
I'm Byron. I'd be here and there, I guess. I don't know.
He's here now. Gone to Molly.
Ew.
Gotta always end on a joke. All right, we'll see you guys next time. Bye. Hey, guys, thanks so much for watching. If you saw that Godzilla and you liked it, if you saw King of the Monsters and you liked that, leave a comment below.
Please subscribe right below, like you said. And, yeah, have a session with us and let us know your opinions on everything, I guess.
Stay safe, stay high.